So we've just arrived, but we're in Nimmu House. We're moving, I think, a couple times from house to house, but it is really, really lovely. The weather is amazing. Dry as a bone. The sun's really warm, but it's got that nice kind of chill edge, mountain edge. Very peaceful.
And the rooms are gorgeous.
Yeah. I'll show you the room in a minute, but it's really nice and kind of simple, elegant. And this is our view. Look at that sky. Rather delicious tea. So guys, it's after breakfast. I'm just on the terrace reading a little bit about Ladakh and where we are. And also having a look at the itinerary for the next few days, which actually looks really nice. This is exactly my kind of thing, just like really super chill, mountainous, countryside, remote. I just love, love, love this kind of thing. And I can't explain to you how nice the weather is, having come from somewhere that's so humid. Not that I'm complaining too much about the time of year we came for Rajasthan, because it was very green and beautiful, because obviously it had been raining when it was usually quite sparse and arid and desert-like, so not complaining too much, because it was good to see everything when it was like at its greenest, but it was so humid and like close, and just not really used to it, to be honest. So it's nice to be in the mountain air, and it's actually quite warm right now. It does feel a good like late 20s. The sun feels really warm and I'm just loving it. But I'm having this ginger tea. So I'm on my second cup and it's also really nice. Yeah, I think we're just chilling for the rest of the day because you've got to acclimatise a little bit to the altitude. We're really quite high here actually. We're at 4,000 metres and I have only ever been to 4,800, and that was really high in Bolivia. I'm just going to show you our room before it gets any more messed up. Look how gorgeous that is. And I've got a little wood burner, look at that. I imagine, well, it's supposed to get pretty chilly at night, so I don't know whether it will get chilly enough to light that, but it might do. I think it said like 10 degrees. Look at this view. And we've got some resident cows, some of which you like to moo a little bit. And they seem to be building something over there. So we just had a rather delicious dinner. I forgot to take my camera down and I couldn't be bothered to come and get it. I think the altitude is maybe affecting my brain a little bit. Oh, and I'm feeling very tired. I've eaten too much, I don't. Feel massively great, but look at that view. Well, it seems to only be coming up like this, like some sort of glowing dome, but obviously in real life it looks quite normal. So guys, Indy and I are going to go to bed now. She's actually already asleep. She didn't have a nap today and we got up at 4:20 or something, so I'm not surprised she's so tired. I think it's about 9. I think we're still pretty tired. And I'm excited to get back to bed. I had a nap earlier, but I'm excited for more sleep. Gave Zach a call just now. I've got this little phone that they've given me. I think it's just a matter of not getting signal on our normal phones and all the houses that we're visiting not having Wi-Fi, so because this seems to have pretty good signal. So gave Zach a call, which was nice, and checking that everything's still okay back at home. It's very strange. It's actually quite relaxing. I wouldn't want to do it all the time, but it's quite relaxing to not be able to check Instagram or like Twitter or check on anything basically, because there's just no option to, so it just feels pretty chilled. But anyway, we're gonna go to sleep now. Actually, I'll show you guys the bathroom whilst I'm in here. I'm just in the middle of my skincare routine. I've got this really nice little sink area. Loo, this is our shower. Been trying not to use too much water because I don't think they have loads of water here in this area. But yeah, it's really cute. Good morning, guys. So today we're off on our walk around Nimue Village. And I'm already feeling a bit out of breath, but I'm sure we'll be fine. Something on my bloody screen. You heard of it. Right. We've had a nice walk around Nimue and we're actually at a different house gonna have a drink in the garden. We're in like a little orchard and it's really nice. I think they're apricots. Greeted with some rather lovely carrot juice, and apparently we're having lunch down by the river, which I'm very excited for. But we had a really nice walk. We were walking for just over 2 hours, so not that long to be honest, but enough for our altitude unready bodies. I feel like I've done some sort of hard workout, like my muscles are twitching and stuff, so that just shows you how much harder it is to do anything pretty much at altitude if you're not used to it anyway. I'm gonna enjoy my carrot juice, wait for lunch, which smells delicious and garlicky. Don't know what it's gonna be, but I'm very excited. That's where we're having lunch. She's copying me. Look at it.
My hair's too big, it doesn't do the same thing.
No, you just have to tie it better, Indy Bear. My hair does that. So guys, we have been relaxing all afternoon since lunch basically. I've had a little sleep, I've read some of my book. I'm reading, oh my god, I've completely forgot his name, Midnight's Children. Which is about independence in India. So yes, that's what I've been reading. I'm about halfway through now. It's like about 600 pages, so it's quite long. So anyway, this afternoon, it's about 4:45 now I think. This afternoon we are going to I think it's an old fort / monastery. I think it's Basco. I'm not entirely sure, but that's where we're going this afternoon. And then we're gonna come back, dinner. Ooh, it smells good. Hi. Good morning, guys. This morning we are off rafting. I swear there is always something on this screen. Pretty exciting, a little bit nerve-wracking because I'm not great. If I'm going to be taught like whitewater rafting, no. I'm hoping it's going to be quite gentle. But we'll see. But yeah, anyway, we're gonna go off rafting this morning. My mum's feeling ill, so she's not coming with us, which is sad. And I don't know whether I'm allowed to take my camera or not, because I might be busy rafting. And I haven't got my GoPro with me this holiday, so we'll have to see. So guys, we just finished our rafting experience. Guess what it was? White water rafting.
Mm-hmm.
Were we expecting that?
No,
not really. So got in our wetsuits and our helmets, and we went for
it. And our weird shoes.
And our weird shoes, and we did it. And
I'm actually
quite glad that we both forced ourselves, despite a little bit of anxiety, to do it. But it was interesting. I think we went for the milder one from the two rivers that you could have done. So we didn't do anything very scary, but we did have some pretty big waves, didn't we?
There were some moments when I was worried I was going to fall off.
Yeah. But it was good. It was good, actually.
Yeah.
I think I would do it again, but just not in the next year. But obviously I couldn't film anything. They were going to put my bag in my camera in a waterproof bag on the raft. And I was thinking, if I'm going to be busy obeying commands and going through rapids, I'm not going to have time to get the camera out. So I left the camera in the car. I'm afraid there's no footage. Look at this sunset, you guys. The way it's hitting those mountains in the back is really pretty. My mind is made up and I wanna go. And I've been thinking about what to do. Been thinking about me, about being you. By locking me out continuously. Let me in. Let me in. So guys, I haven't spoken to you in a while since our rafting experience. I'm really sad that I didn't get any footage of us rafting or anything, because it was so funny. But oh well. Ooh, sometimes you just gotta live, guys. Sometimes you just gotta live. We've had a very relaxing afternoon. I've done lots of reading. I'm quite far through my book now, and I've just started doing some editing as well, which I'm gonna finish off. Ooh, my contact lens has gone so weird. Which I'm gonna finish off after dinner. But now it's dinner time, and I'm so excited because I'm so hungry. Something smells nice. Is it you?
Possibly. Do I smell like fruits?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's me.
Okay. Anywho,
smell of fruits.
Time for some delicious dinner. But first we have drinks and our little library thing. Tomorrow we're leaving here. I'm quite sad about it because it's been really cute and nice. That frame of mind. Let me tell you, I don't need nobody. So guys, just had a lovely dinner. I've finished editing my Jaipur and Agra vlog. So I'm pleased that's done. I'm going to rewatch it in the morning. But that's pretty much done, I think. I realise I sound really unenthusiastic about most things that we're doing. And that's not because I'm not enthusiastic. I just very rarely express my enthusiasm. Particularly if it's early in the morning. Doesn't mean I'm not appreciative or enjoying myself. I keep vlogging in my room because it's just easier sometimes than vlogging when you're out and about. Especially when you're in a strange place. And when I'm in my room, I'm kind of like past whatever we're doing, so I don't always sound quite as enthused, but it doesn't mean that I'm not. I'm just that's just what I'm like. I don't express my enthusiasm for many things, and if I do, it's usually because I'm just in like a talkative, chatty, fun mood. So yes, it's just me. But anyway, I am going off to sleep now, I think. I hope. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the morning. Bye. So guys, this morning we are leaving the lovely village of Nimmu. It's been a really nice day. I really like this little house as well. It's been very cozy and homely. But yeah, we're off today. We're spending one night in, can you remember what it's called, Indy?
No.
Likar? Something like that. But we're on our way. We're gonna see a monastery. We're gonna have a picnic, which I'm excited for. And yeah, That's our day. We're going to see another monastery in the evening once we've arrived at our next house. But I think that's everything for now. Nobody but me. And I want you back. Those things I ever said, regret seeing that. Funny how I never saw it before. I guess sometimes gotta walk out the door. Don't it always seem to go? You don't know what you got. So we just visited Alchi Monastery, which is a rare example of Indian Buddhism. I think all the other monasteries in this area, a lot of them are Tibetan influence, but we couldn't film the temples, so I couldn't show you guys the beautiful bits of that. It wasn't much to see from the outside. It was like a monastery complex. So we just stopped off for our picnic lunch in another orchard, which is rather beautiful, and I'll show you the mountains outside in a minute. Very excited because I'm very hungry. Goodbye luncheon, you were lovely, and now we're off to our new home. We've just arrived in Lakia, and this is our lovely little room with a pretty gorgeous view. Look at that. You can see the snow on the mountains still over there. It's the afternoon, I think. I'm going to maybe do some more editing. And then we're going to go walk down to the Lakia Monastery. So we've had a couple hours chill time. I've just edited my Delhi vlog, which I'm pleased about because I'm pretty much caught up now. Today, I'm really hungry. I ate quite a lot for lunch as well, so I don't really understand why I'm so hungry. But we've got tea before we make our way to the monastery. And I need to take some more painkillers because yesterday, doing the rafting, I must have really used my arms and my back because they really hurt today, but not in like a satisfying, post-workout way. They really, like, I've got this really strained feeling, so I probably should have done some sort of warm-up or something, I don't know, but it feels really like there's fire running through my muscles or something. It's horrible. So I'm gonna take some more painkillers as well, which is so ridiculous. That shows you how unfit I am. Apparently half yak, half cow. Had a really nice trip to Lakia Monastery. It's actually a working monastery, so it's a little bit different from the other ones that we've seen. And it also had this room, museum room, where it had, because basically I think a lot of it was destroyed 200 years ago in a fire. So it had a museum room of all the stuff, or a lot of the stuff that the monks had saved from the fire. Some of which was just hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years old, which was really fascinating, so I enjoyed that. And we saw the little monk school as well, which was pretty cute. They were, I think, having their dinner or something, or maybe they were singing away anyway. It was very sweet. But anywho, I am all washed, absolutely starving. I don't know what's got into me. We're higher here, and I feel like I've been hungrier here than I usually am. They say that altitude is supposed to give you lack of appetite, but I seem to have more of an appetite. But anyway, we're high here. We're at 3,800 meters now, and we were about, I think we're about 3,200 or 3,400. I don't really know, but you can tell the difference in air a little bit.
We had the fire on in our little living room. So nice, but now it's time for dinner.
Whatever she thinks is interesting, which I should have done ages ago. I do need somebody. I need my baby. So we just tried to go and see the monastery at Ley, but apparently all the monks are still out listening to the teachings of the Dalai Lama, so couldn't go inside, but there's been a good view of Ley. That high peak over there. That's the highest peak in this region, I think. It's make your own Burmese soup day. Yummy pizza! So guys, we arrived in our stock house a few hours ago, and now we are going to have a cooking lesson downstairs, which is exciting.
So this is a fairly spicy chili, this one?
Oh, no, it's a mild chili, chef. Mild, not so spicy. And just add cumin seed.
What was that again?
Hing. Yeah. And the onion.
I'll eat yours, Jess.
Trust him, mother.
We won't know the difference.
I think we'll know the small one and the fat one.
We might know the little one.
That was a bit, a little bit violent. I think that it's...
No, she didn't.
That's really lovely. Yeah. Yummy soup. I'm just so eating your soup. So I haven't spoken to you today, but I did film a little bit of our lunch. We've had breakfast and lunch out in the orchard. But basically, our cooking lesson last night was really enjoyable. It was just really fascinating to watch what was in our dinner, basically. And I really enjoyed it. And then we had dinner and then we went to sleep. And then today we were going to have the morning just chilling. So I've done most of my editing of my main channel videos for the next few weeks, which should hopefully... I do have to film one in between, but it should hopefully keep me going well into moving into my flat in Edinburgh, which is good. But I still have a bit more to do. And the family have actually gone on a walk around stock, which I've been really bad, and I've decided not to go. But I've sent Indy with the camera, so I'll insert whatever footage that she took here. We've gone off on a walk around the stock. Jessie stayed back at the house editing, so she's asked me to film for her, which is exciting. It's super, super pretty. Very out of breath. Oh, he looks like a baby. There's a big one. You're a bit smelly. I just stepped in a massive puddle. And now my foot's really wet. Birkin stocks were not the best idea. What a beautiful sight. So we're up in the palace now.
Christened him Trevor for some reason.
Jess likes it. So she's being me for the purposes of the walk, but I just needed to finish off my editing, and I really wanted it all done so that in the Maldives I could just chill out a little bit more. And this afternoon / evening I think a monk is coming to the house, which is quite exciting, and we're going to ask him some questions and just learn about monastic life. And then tomorrow we are leaving for Colombo for a night, which is in Sri Lanka. We're staying near the airport in Colombo and then travelling on to the Maldives from there.
And we are believing everything is interdependent, cause and effect, causality. You know, everything depends on each other.
Mm-hmm.
So, and we are believing to the karma. And karma,
yeah.
You know. So if we do good, have good,
mm-hmm.
like that. So the, and we are not believing, and is there any supreme beings? Then we go to the highest Lama to request. I would like to have this highest.
Additional
thing. Yeah. There's a 252.
And you have to take them all?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And but there's a main four roots vow.
Okay.
There's four roots
mm-hmm.
vow. If we lose one of these vow, and then useless to be a monk, it's much more better to go back and get married and be a lay people.
Okay.
You know, others vows, you know, rest of the vows, except the four main root vow. You know, we are doing good thing or bad thing. We are doing through three things, through three different parts. through our body, through our speech, and through our mind. And I guess, Catholic or in Christian religion, there's a 10 commitment.
Yes.
Yep.
We divided those 10 virtues into three categories. Three from body, and then four from speech, and three from mind. And through body, not killing, not stealing, not sexual with misconduct. And then four from speech,
mm-hmm.
not lying, not slandering,
mm-hmm.
not gossiping, not using harsh word. See? And then the last three, through our mind. Not coveting,
coveting,
you got it, you know? And then not planning to harm others. And then the last one is come through religions. You know, taking a wrong view. Without study, without knowing, without investigations, for our every religions. So yeah, I belong to Buddhist, and I have that kind of view, you know. If I haven't taken those that kind of wrong view, you know, what is Buddha? Who is Buddha? Where? What is sin? Virtue? And next life, past life, you know. So that kind of thought, that kind of view, you know, without judging, without understanding, without knowing. After study, after investigating, and after fully understand, then that is exception.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we just had our conversation with the monk who came to see us, and it was really, really interesting. He talked to us about everything from his like daily routine to a lot of Buddhist teaching and the kind of basic tenets of Buddhism and the different types of Buddhism. I like the emphasis on study and like teaching and thinking for yourself and all of this kind of stuff.
What are you doing? You're doing a lot of mean things.
Let me play Sudoku.
I'm playing it.
Yeah, but I found it too.
Okay, well, let me do it, please.
You little poo.
Yeah, I think you've got it wrong.
Snug.
Created a monster.
And it's of your own doing.
I've created it.
I've got an itchy nosh. Anyway, you're on my bed.
I'm not on your bed.
This is my bed.
I bought this bed.
No, Jess. That's your bed.
Yes. Dinner
time. I'm
trying to play a game of solitaire.
It's not solitaire. I did that earlier, and now you're doing it because you run to the family.
Let's go to dinner.
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 Let's eat some biscuits. It's in there.
Okay.
So I've added my noodles and what they call the gravy. Now I'm going to add all of these. So we just had a delicious dinner. We had some sort of Burmese thing. I can't really remember what it was called, but it was really nice. And now I'm definitely ready for bed. I'm just sorting out my hand luggage, ready for the intense airport experience. I'm actually going to end Ladakh's vlog here, even though we're not leaving till tomorrow morning, because I don't think I'm going to vlog for the next couple of days, or I will vlog when I land in the Maldives, but it's going to be travelling days. We're going to be in Colombo obviously tomorrow night, but we're only going to be in the hotel. We're not going to see any of it, so I think it would just be better not to vlog for the next couple of days. So I really hope you enjoyed the Ladakh vlog. I've loved it here. I love these kind of mountainous regions. It really reminds me of my gap here and Patagonia. It's been really beautiful. The people are lovely. The food's been great, and the houses have been really nice as well. I forgot to show you my room here actually, but I had my own room. Although India's just through there, through our bathroom. But I had this rather lovely large room. I've had to switch to the other camera because that camera just literally died on me. But thank you guys so much for watching. And I will see you for the Maldives vlog, which is very exciting. Bye!